Okay, fine, fine, fine. We can begin. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, so this is Shobha from Citizen News Service, and on behalf of APCAT, that is Asia Pacific Cities Alliance for Tobacco Control and Non-Communicable Disease Prevention, whose secretariat is housed in the International Union Against Tuberculosis. A warm-up session before we really plunge into the eyes of 4th APCAT. Let us break the ice by introducing ourselves. I would like all of us who are present here, I would request each of you to just share your name and organization, and also tell very briefly what is your top expectation from the 4th APCAT. I would set the ball rolling. I'm Shobha Shukla from Citizen News Service, or CNS as we call ourselves. And my expectation is to learn more about actions that are being taken at the local level to strengthen tobacco and NCB control efforts at regional and global levels. I strongly believe that the rules and policies and laws that are framed at national levels, they have to be actually carried out and implemented at the ground level. So without local action, we are really not going to achieve much. And that is why what I expect to learn and then write upon and spread the word of what is happening across so many cities. Now please take over from me. The next one, I think Hoang, would you like to say, introduce yourself?
Hello, my name is Hoang. I'm 29 years old. I'm from Vietnam, Dân Trí newspaper. My expectation to the summit that we can share the knowledges about the problems of the banning cigarettes in local levels in our countries, because I think it's bringing a lot of benefit to the communities. Thank you very much.
Great. Kalpana? Is Kalpana there? Or maybe Noorul would like to share. We don't have any particular order. It's a open group.
Thank you. My name is Noorul Islam Hasib. I am from Bangladesh. My news organization is bdnews24.com. Can you listen me?
Hello? Yes.
Oh, okay. So my expectation is, in Bangladesh we have both problems. NCBs are rising, and tobacco is a big problem because of the industry influence here. And we have a strong law, but in implementation-wise, it's not working very well. Read the news stories. And I used to cover this tobacco issues for long, but since long time. But in the last 1 year, I would say I did not follow the international, where the things are going on, what things are going on internationally. I did not follow much. So I think this conference will be for me, it will give me a latest update, what is happening. Because particularly the tobacco issues, even the NCDs, what my understanding is all the globally, the things are same, because the industry, they apply the same tricks everywhere. So I think it will be a learning opportunity. And from the conference, I will cover interesting stories for my outlet bdnews24.com.
Great, Noorul. And it's in fact for all of us to reinforce and rediscover new things and new action plans from the conference. Great.
Yeah.
Kalpana, are you there with us? Kalpana, please unmute yourself. If you have muted yourself, we can't hear you. Okay, maybe Kalpana is having some technical problems at her end. Padam Raj Joshi ji. Please see that you are unmuted from your end. Padam Raj Joshi, he's there.
I think there's no mic icon next to Mr. Joshi's name, so I don't think his mic is on.
No, Mr. Joshi, there's no mic there. Yes, I can see no mic there. Kalpana is also having some problem, is it?
It must be, but okay, I mean...
Can we continue? Do we continue? Yes. Okay. And as and then when they join in, they can introduce themselves maybe as soon as they are online.
Open chat, Kalpana is online, so you guys can...
Yes, but Kalpana, we can't hear her. For some reason, I do not know why we are not able to hear her. Kalpana, are you there?
Yeah, she has some problem with the video, so that's why she can hear us.
She can hear us, so maybe she switches, even if she can talk, even if we can't see her video, even if we can listen to her, that could be okay. Because sometimes an internet connection is weak, that problem is there. I have switched off my video for that reason, the connection was a little weak.
Yeah, I will switch off. I think you can switch everybody's video out from yourself.
No, but that will depend upon our end, no? That is fine, yes, because... If Kalpana's connection is weak, then she will be having a problem. Mm. If the connection is fine, then it doesn't matter. No, and please don't. We don't want Tara's video to be switched off at all. Never. Okay, I think we will continue. Now we will get to have a glimpse of the highlights of the 4th APCAT Summit, even before we are there. Thanks to Dr. Tara Singh Baum, Deputy Director for Asia Pacific Region at the International Union Against Tuberculosis and Lung Disease. And he has helped shape. Just a moment, please. He has helped shape and support the Asia Pacific Cities Alliance for Tobacco Control and Non-Communicable Disease Prevention. And over to you, Tara.
Thank you, Shobha, and hello all.
Yes, hello.
It's really great to to have our this virtual meetings debrief you all about the APCAT. Thanks, Bobby and Shobha, for coordinating this with all the media and also helping us in shaping up the agenda and the other logistics as well. Thanks to CNS. Regarding the APCAT, just quickly, I would like to update you. The APCAT stands for Asia Pacific Cities Alliance for Tobacco Control and Prevention of NCD. NCD prevention. It has been established in 2016 with 12 cities from Asia Pacific countries, and then in 2017 the membership has been grown to 23 cities from 10 countries, and in 2018 actually it has been grown to 40 cities in Asia Pacific from 12 countries. What we have seen from the key objective of this alliance is to really identify the local solutions and the local the resources and the local actions and the local stakeholders. So all the key goal is to really the work at the local level to address the issue of the NCDs and tobacco. So that's why the primary elements of any intervention is political commitment. At the subnational level, we see the leaders can play a really critical role to deliver the best practices to save lives and, you know, from the different, yeah. So we work with some the city mayors to how we can gain the local political wills and what type of the supports that they need from the different stakeholders at the local level, how these cities the mayors needs the help from the national governments, national policymakers, for example, from member of parliaments and the senior government official from the different ministries at the national level. So again, the key objective is to really gain the political will to identify the local solutions, and those solutions needs to be translated into action. So that is the key objective of this the EPICAT, as Shobha mentioned earlier. So we really would like to see the action on the ground with effective the strategies and the resources. So in this the journey in 2018, so we have added some other key elements in the EPICATs. That is one of the key elements is the member of parliament, and the second one is the media. So the media's role always very very influencing and critical for any the health and development the sector. So we would like to really enhance the media engagements with the local leaders and also the national policymakers. Once the media there, so the media is the media is the only one that make the that can really contribute to make accountable of the leaders and the policymakers, whatever they have committed. So in this regards, we have invited you for this EPICAT, and that would be also great opportunities to have the personal one-to-one the meeting with the different leaders from the leader or mayor from your own country, and also the cross country as well. So it's a wonderful opportunity really to document the voice of the local leaders and also make them accountable. In this the summit we have we will have about the maybe the Savita will brief about the participation about the high-level peoples and also mayors and the different stakeholders in the meeting in a few minutes. The objective is actually from you guys, and as I mentioned, media is the main pillar of the of any programs. What we really would like to have some your guidance and also the inputs, as we discussed last year in 2018 EPICAT summit in Singapore. In this summit, we would be the thinking about whether we can establish Asia Pacific the media the alliance under the theme of the EPICAT, so that that media can really help more effective ways to our the leaders at the country level. So that is the one of the discussion points I would like to put forward here. So we can think about this, and everyone can think, and then once we are in the Bogor city, we can discuss further. But my request to you about your the opinion as well. So I pause here. I would like to hand over to Savita. Would you like to just highlight the part?
Yeah.
Can I just intervene a bit? We all of us know Savita Karapan. She is from the Asia Pacific Regional Office of the Union, and a tremendous help to the APCAT secretariat. Where will we be without you, Savita? Yes, now you can speak.
I will be nowhere without you guys either. I will send you guys the full participant list, but for now I would like to highlight that we have mayors from each of your countries coming down. We also have members of parliament, and we will have some probably some ministers from, or maybe some ministers from Indonesia coming down. So the full list it's almost ready, so I could probably send that to you today. Of course, there's always additions. Always going to be additions all the way up to the conference itself. So, but you can use this list for like a tentative confirmation. What else would you like to know?
We'll have about 250 to 300 participants in the conference. Then majority of them will be from the Indonesia, the local mayors and the senior government of from national level. From the international, from other countries, will have around 70 to 80 participants. So, and they have already confirmed it.
Yeah. Okay. Savita, anything more you want to add? No, that's it?
Nothing in particular, no.
Okay. I would request the participants, some of you might have joined in late, some are having some technological issues, I think. So you can speak, please unmute yourself at your end. You would be seeing the mute unmute button on your screen. So either unmute yourself or you can use the chat function to write down something if you want to, if you want to convey. But those who are there and who can use their mics, please introduce yourself and the organization you represent, and also in very briefly say what is your top expectation from the fourth APCAT. Two people have already shared this, the others please go ahead. I can see Tin, if I'm pronouncing it correctly, or the name. So please unmute yourself and join us. Our doctor from Myanmar is also there, please. Yes.
I would like to know the participants from Myanmar, both parliamentarian and other persons, and send me the list of the Myanmar representatives. Mm-hmm. And I also like to interview with some of them. Mm-hmm.
What is your top expectation from the fourth APCAT? And please introduce yourself also, because others may, we know you, but others may not be knowing who are here online.
I am Tim Montray, chief editor, health digest journal from Myanmar. Okay?
Yes. And what is your top expectation from the fourth APCAT?
My topic? Of expectation.
Yes. One expectation, which the topmost expectation you have.
Yeah, I would like to learn the how the Asia Pacific cities are implementing their smoke-free cities, their strategies, and how the challenges and difficulties that they are facing. I would like to know. Okay. I would like to focus on that point.
Okay. Is Kalpana able to join us? It's so unfortunate Kalpana is not able to connect to us. She's very much there. Okay. So I'll continue with. So as Tara mentioned, that APCAT, attending the fourth APCAT, as has been attending the past APCAS, is an opportunity for us to get the best inputs from local government political leaders, mayors, and other public health experts on tobacco control and NCDs prevention. And people come from different cities, that we have got a glimpse of that. Now, what do we do to help realize the fourth APCAT's goals. How can we help? We who are here, as Tara is placing too high an expectation on us. But obviously, we have to write powerful stories. That is what I feel my aim would be, that we write powerful stories that have the best impact to reduce preventable burden of NCDs. And as we know, NCDs are responsible for 70% of all deaths globally. And tobacco is a big risk factor for most of these NCDs. So just to remind ourselves, here we can discuss that while we are on site at the conference or even before that, how can we make our story more impactful and increase its reach? What questions to ask, whom to ask, just to have a bigger impact, because that is what we can do by writing. We cannot treat a person who is suffering from some NCD or who is facing ill effects of tobacco control, but we can do our bit to prevent tobacco use or limit that. And that is where sometimes it is said that the pen is mightier than the sword, or the pen is mightier than the surgeon's knife. So here we have tried to frame some questions which might be useful to all of us in helping us add more power to our stories. They are by no means complete. This is just a small list. And you are welcome to use them and, of course, add to the list. So now, how can we help with pre-APCAT summit news stories? Some of you might be writing stories before you even land in Bogor. So if we can help in any way, we are just call away or WhatsApp message away to be of any help. And then, how can we support on-site on Bogor? And of course, by we, I mean myself, and I think Bobby has not introduced himself. Is it possible for Bobby to introduce himself also? So that we know who we are looking up to there.
Yes, sure. Hi everyone. This is Bobby Rabakant, and I'm right now in Delhi from in India, and really look forward to meeting you all in Bogor. Thanks, Shubha. Over to you, Ben. Okay.
Now, on-site in Bogor, again, as has been mentioned earlier, that our aim is to have powerful stories. And all of you are welcome to discuss with us, with Bobby and myself, to use us as a sounding board to help shape story ideas. You all are all very senior journalists. There's no doubt about it. But as Nurul said, he mentioned that he has been out of the tobacco control scene for some time. Very good writer. But maybe, so sometimes we need each other's help to help shape story ideas. We can help schedule interviews. Depending upon what your story is about, we can suggest the right type of people you can interview, or if you have specific people in mind, like our friend from Myanmar said he would like to interview some, so we can help arrange those interviews. We will try our best. We can help you find the resource data and any position papers written around tobacco control, NCD prevention, even APCAT declaration from last year, just to bolster what we write. Also, we can live stream. If you intend to take some on-site interviews, we can live stream the interviews you are doing. Of course, taking your consent and taking after consent of the person who's being interviewed. And they can be live streamed on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, or on your page, and so that others can see the interview going on live. Also, we will try our best for any other specific needs you have, say interview space, or as I said earlier, scheduling interviews, suggesting, just giving suggestions whom you could interview depending upon your story idea. And one thing I would like to request is that what you are writing, say, before you land in Bogor or while you are there, or some stories you might be completing after the fourth EpiCat is over. Please, please share the clippings and links of stories written by you that have been published via our email, via email address or our WhatsApp number, so that we can help promote what you have written through our social media channels to amplify their impact and increase readership and coverage. Please share them with Sabita also. So the whole idea is to reach as many people as possible and do our little bit to reach the end game of tobacco and to do away with NCTs. Now, we've just written down a few questions, some questions we thought are good to interview. So you can see them. One question could be, what advice do you have from governments that are facing pressure from tobacco industry and their front groups? And the good persons to ask this, if this question is fitting into your storyline, is to ask the mayor of Bogor and mayor of Klungkung. Am I pronouncing this correctly, Tara? Klungkung?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. So, because as we know, the tobacco industry, not only directly, but indirectly, they have so many of their front groups and they are there's a lot of pressure faced by governments to just water down tobacco control laws and many, many other tactics. So that could be one good question. Another one could be, what are your goals for the rest of 2019 and 2020 for your city? Now, this question again could be asked of the mayors who are there and the political leaders. Because what I have seen in the past EpiCats is that also the mayors and the local political leadership and other leaders, MPs who are present there, they make certain goals that this year we will do these actions. Maybe action could be as simple as that we will try to have more parks in the city for people to walk inside. I think which is very important for NCT control. So Last EpiCat also, they made, certain goals were made, and we will get to hear this year what has been the work in progress on them. So this could be another good question to ask again of the mayors and political leadership. This is an interesting question. If you had to convince a close relative to stop smoking or using tobacco in any other form, what would you do or say? And I think this question it can be asked of anyone. We can ask each other this question also, because that is also our aim. It's not only the political leaders and the mayors, but it is about each one of us, because we have to convince a close relative. And I will personally, from personal experience, when I've been talking of these things, I have found it a little bit more hard to convince people from quitting chewing tobacco or the smokeless form of tobacco. But when I spoke about cigarette smoking, I said, because I from a smoker, I get this answer, well, how does it matter to you? It's my life and I want to live it the way I want to. But there the quick rebuttal is that, well, it's your life is what matters to you, but you don't have to take other people's lives in your hands. And in my case, this argument has worked. This they found convincing, yes, because secondhand smoke is also jeopardizing our health. And to that, they did not have an answer. I'm just giving an example, but there could be other ways and forms. I have seen children throwing a tantrum at home to their father, or could be mother also, that unless you quit smoking, we are not going to do this, we are not going to listen. So children power is a huge power. If they decide on something, they get it done. And it has happened in some cases that they succeeded in their attempts. So again, this is a question which can be asked of anybody. Another one is, what is the value of EpiCat for? Again, this question could be directed to the mayors, MPs, and the political leadership. And is there anything that you have learned from attending EPICAT that you didn't know before? And I'm sure they would share, because it is a, it's a experience sharing platform also. So, because mayors, we have come across and very, very interesting and innovative initiatives which some people have taken at their city level in their cities, just for this cause of tobacco control and NCD prevention. So this will give us a lot of information, I think, what is actually happening at the ground level, local level, and what is working and what is not working. Because it's very often, there's a, these days, again, from personal experience, I can say there's a lot of hype on, not hype, rightly so, on physical exercise and going to parks and walking. But we do need to have safe spaces for walking also. And unless we create those spaces, it's not everybody's cup of tea to join a gym for the physical to go and do physical exercise. So I think there are small actions at the local level which go, having cycle tracks in your city. I think that is another, maybe a small action, but it can go a long way in supporting our cause. So these could be a lot of learnings, and if these questions, the answers to these questions can really help shape up some of our stories. Another one is, what, very similar to what advice do you have for your country, city, in terms of health and well-being? Again, it will relate to actions taken by the local leadership, the mayors and MPs in their constituencies. Another one is, as I had also mentioned, the laws are there, but they are implemented on the ground level. So we know it's not enough to have laws. We must also make sure that people follow them. And how do you tackle smoke, or how have you tackled smoke-free enforcement in your city or country or regional level? And I think these are important questions, and the answers to them and the stories we develop there, that will feed into the global and regional efforts for the end game of tobacco and to prevent NCDs. Another very burning question is, e-cigarettes and other new emerging tobacco products, they already are the next tsunami perhaps of products from the tobacco industry. And what steps are you taking or will take to tackle this rising public health issue? Again, this can be asked of political leaders and mayors, and the public health expert can also talk about why is it important to ban these products. That is a lot these days. I think there's a lot of news about some deaths occurring in the US because of, and let us not limit ourselves to e-cigarettes. I think there are, what we have, Juul, and we have what they call IQOS, I quit ordinary smoking. So now they are promoting, the tobacco industry is promoting perhaps extraordinary smoking, whatever they mean by it. But it is now the health hazards are being very, very visible, resulting in deaths. And there is news that FDA is very soon going to come out with new regulations and laws. Many cities, they have already banned the some of these products, the flavored products, I think. The e-cigarettes which have flavored products, they have been banned. So again, this is one of our participants also mentioned about e-cigarettes. And I think this is again a very, very burning topic on which we can write. So the list is endless. Again, are epidemics caused by tobacco and NCDs harming our nation's economy? Because very often we talk of the health hazards of that, and we somehow tend to overlook the economic hazards. And sometimes a plea is also given that if we are going to lose a lot of revenue if we stop the sale of cigarettes or tobacco products. And I'm sure the best person to ask about this is a public health expert like Dr. Tara Singh Baum. He would be the best person to answer this question, and other public health experts you would be meeting there. So Then another is, has local action helped in enforcement of tobacco control and NCD prevention in the Asia-Pacific region? Now, Asia-Pacific region, again, because it is from the local inputs we get, which is happening at local level, that we get a picture for the entire region. And again, a very good person to ask this question is Dr. Baum. Ara would be the best person. So here you've got our, I think, Bobby, if you can get back to that slide so people can note down these numbers. And we are just, as I said, a phone call or an email or a WhatsApp message away. And regarding the questions, the list is endless. The best questions will depend upon the kind of story we are trying to frame. So we have to add, and we can help each other. We can help you depending upon your story. The aim is to have a powerful story and let it reach the maximum number of people we possibly can. Sabita, would you like to talk something about logistics or just to wrap up?
Thank you, Shubha. That's very good. So I've sent around travel tips to all of you. If you haven't received it, please let me know. But just to summarize, when you go fly into Jakarta Airport, the ground transfer will be organized for you. So you look for the AP CAT sign and just follow the driver. The journey from the airport to Bogor City is about 2 hours, maybe three, depending on traffic, depending on what time you land. The hotel name is the Grand Sabero. So that's where you'll be staying, and that's where the event is as well. There will be a media room also for you, so you can work in there. Can write your stories in there or do your interviews in there, or anything that you would like to use that room for. But for more detailed information, I will also pass around my WhatsApp. So if you have any other questions that you think about after this, you can also email me or WhatsApp me. But thank you all very much. Just to wrap up from my side, very much for joining this call, and we definitely look forward to seeing all of you there. We really hope that we can hold the very meaningful interview, something that we quote, that we can grab from and we can use all the way until the end of the next fifth APCAT. So the quotes that you get from these interviews, we will take and we will use them for the rest of the year and all the way until next APK. So it will be really, really very useful.
Just one more point I wanted to add. In fact, I'm trying to remind myself over and over again, because till now when I used to write APCAT, I would write AP-CAT. Now that dash has disappeared. So when we are mentioning APCAT, then it is APCAT with no dash or hyphen between P and C. So just I think Sabita told us about that, and I'm reminding all of us, because I have the tendency to write, till now I have been writing like that. So the new logo is on the screen, you can, as all of you can see, and there is no hyphen or dash between P and C. So just when we are writing our stories, but just to put the right thing, that's all I had to say. And will any of the participants like to add something or share something or want to say something? Please be welcome to use the chat function or speak. Anyone? Oh, I think Sabita has done a good job, and Tara has explained everything so well about the highlights. Yes?
Shubha and all, thank you. That's my special request. We have two slots still, you know, that we can for the media. So if you have anyone, especially the, we haven't got anyone from either Malaysia or Philippines. If you guys have some
Okay.
You know, the local contact.
Okay, we'll try. Yes, we'll see. Definitely, we'll see. Okay, so now do we say bye-bye and meet in Bogor?
Yeah, okay, thank you.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.